Video games have never been faster, brighter, and more detailed. Hurry up and don't miss out on this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. The brand new, improved and cheap as chips GeForce 2 MX400.
Hello, my friends. It's 2001 and I have in front of me something that could bring happiness or misery in our lives. A GeForce 2 MX400 video card. But why do I say this? It's simple. I have two GeForce 2 MX400 here. An ugly one on the left, a gorgeous one on the right. Let's take a closer look. What would we have chosen as a 10-year-old geek that loves computers? This or that? Well, obviously, this. It's shiny, it has an extremely beautiful blue color, and on top of that, it says Abit, the top manufacturer for computer enthusiasts. I remember even now talking to a friend, he was very excited that he had upgraded his video card. He recently bought a GeForce 2 MX400 and he said, I quote, "Not just any GeForce 2, it's an Abit Siluro." Wow, I said, great, I have a GeForce 2 no name, green and ugly, just like this. But sometimes life has some surprises in store for us. And tonight I want to show you that this is actually 2 times faster than this. Well, maybe, we'll see. Looking at the specs, we see that the cards are similar. There are only 2 differences. The ugly one has a 128-bit memory bus, while the other only 64-bit. And there is also a small difference in memory frequencies, but nothing significant. This means that one of them has a bandwidth of 2.4 GB, while the other has 1.4 GB, almost half. Bandwidth is very important because data is transferred from the video card processor to the video card memory through this bandwidth, and the higher resolutions or visual options we use, the more bandwidth we need. The test platform is a Pentium 4 Northwood clocked at 3 GHz with 1 GB of DDR400 MHz memory and Intel 865 chipset motherboard, and a Seasonic power supply for power. I have 2 hard drives and some games. That's about it. This is one of my favorite computers. It pains me to destroy its inner peace, but I'll do this for all of you fine folks. You're welcome. Sometimes the hardest choices require the strongest will. Already a regular of this channel, Quake 2 can still cause problems for video cards from the early 2000s, even though the game was released in 1997. I'm not using a high resolution right now, only 800x600 high settings, and 32-bit. 32-bit which could cause problems for some video cards that did not have enough bandwidth. Looking at each frame, the video card with 128-bit is faster by 60-70%. What do you think? You went to the store to buy a new video card, the specs were not fully shown, and you had a 50% chance of getting a 50% worse card. Running the in-game benchmark at various resolutions, we see how the 8-bit card loses ground in front of the other, as we increase the resolution, 52%, 57%, and 64% at 1024x768. I'm using Anti-Aliasing 2X to see the performance drop. It's known that video cards from this generation, and the next generation, and the one after that, and the one after the next, and the one after, were not great when using Anti-Aliasing. Yes, a performance drop as drastic as it is beautiful. It's almost poetic to reach almost a third of the performance, after adding Anti-Aliasing 2X. Honestly, I don't even know how to show the differences. Both cards for all resolutions remain with around 40% of the initial performance after activating Anti-Aliasing. Looking at the 1% lows, that is the frames that really matter, because these performance drops can tell us if we will have a smooth experience or if the game will have annoying stutters or slowdowns. And here we have between 50 and 70% performance differences. It's clear to everyone that in absolutely all tests, the 128-bit version will be faster. Who thought that creating a video card with both SDR and 64-bit memory is a good idea? Atrocious. Star Wars Episode 1 Racer is a very fast-paced game. The pod, that is what we fly with, moves fast, and to handle it you have to make fast, sudden movements, the game being very responsive. That is precisely why we must have a very okay frame rate. 30 is out of the question, somewhere around 50 would be perfect. With an almost perfect synchronization between the races, the 128-bit card is around 40% faster, absolutely superb. As I've said, 30fps for this game is not ideal, but if that's what we have, that's what you play. The 128-bit card always has around 50fps, and no, In 1999, I wasn't picky, but now I am. I want 50. What I like a lot about this game is that you always have boost at your disposal. Load it, press the button and the pod goes crazy. Drive fast, the engine heats up, turn off the boost and so on. You can also repair the engine if the damage is not extensive, but I don't know the shortcut. I've always liked to just move forward. Press W to the maximum, don't leave the finger, it's all or nothing. The chances that in 2001 you would find yourself in an internet cafe where at least two high school students fed up with chemistry were engaged in Quake 3 deathmatch running on a GeForce 2MX were at least 50%, but maybe one of them got the computer with the 8-bit and the other with the 128-bit card. And it was perfect. When you couldn't blame the mouse or the keyboard, you blamed the video card. Stutters, lag, the whole package. And yeah, we understand, when there is a difference of 70-80% between the cards, suddenly, hitting the keyboard doesn't sound that bad. I mean, there's no way we can play Quake 3 at 22 FPS. It just doesn't work. You're shooting anywhere and anything, but not the enemy. Now, it's a known strategy that if you need more performance, you use 16-bit instead of 32. And yes, I remember even now that there were many games that I couldn't play with my GeForce 2, Undying, for example. This is the performance when using 16-bit. At 800x600, both cards have excellent performance, the 128-bit version having over 200 FPS. Well, the CPU also helps a lot, don't get me wrong, especially since the Pentium 4 was always a champion in Quake 3, beating the Atom XP in every test. If we move to 32-bit, the performance decreases, obviously. At 800x600, the results are quite strange. The performance drops by 67% for the 8-bit card, while with the other card the performance drops by more than 2 times, a huge drop. At 1024x768, the performance is cut in half for both video cards. This is because the GeForce 2MX 400 video cards needed more bandwidth. Even the 128-bit one doesn't have enough. That's why I recommend 16-bit for this card also, in some games. Anti-aliasing in Quake 3 is, well, it exists, you can use it. And keep in mind that I use 2x, not 4x or more. The 8-bit card has a drastic drop for both resolutions, 2.5 times. Even at 800x600, you won't have a great experience with this game. If the average is 37, I assume that in the areas where there are no enemies and projectiles from weapons, we have somewhere around 50 plus FPS, and during combat, something like 20 plus. On the other hand, the other video card has a 50% drop. We will have half of the original FPS, which is not great. You won't play this game at 1024x768, 25 average FPS is ridiculous, but at 800x600 we have 62 FPS. So, during combat, we will probably gravitate around 30-40 FPS, which is okay. Yes, to play Quake 3 decently on the 8-bit card, you'll need maximum 1024x768 medium to high settings, but 16-bit. It is what it is. On the other card, you can play at the same resolution, but using 32-bit. And this is the difference between the cards. You'll need to use 16-bit on the 8-bit card, 32-bit on the other card. Double the bits, double the fun. Medal of Honor Allied Assault is a classic from 2001 and a game that runs on the Quake 3 engine. The intro is scripted, so we should have the same scene in both situations. I'm not saying that the 128-bit card has double the performance, but it's not far. Let's say between 50 and 70% differences, just like for the other games. And although I still have a few games to show, I could say that we have differences from 50 to 70% between the cards in most tests. I think that this is a huge difference between two video cards with exactly the same name. What do you guys think? Looking closely at how the game runs on this card with 128-bit, for a budget video card released in the same year as the game at 800x600 high settings 32-bit, I think that the card performs quite well. Again, I also have a powerful CPU, but this CPU appeared in 2003. It would not have been unusual to have a Pentium 4 Northwood and a GeForce 2MX 400 in 2003. Moving to a more challenging game from 2002, Serious Sam the Second Encounter starts to cause problems for both cards. At 640x480, the 8-bit has around 30 FPS, and sometimes below. I can't say that it's really that bad, but it seems that here too we should switch to 16-bit. Moving to 800x600, things go down really bad for 8-bit, and we reach an area where the game becomes heavy. Below 20fps is not okay. I feel like me 22 years ago when I was playing this game, and I don't want to be me from 20 years ago. Although I don't want to be me from now either. Bummer. I ran some in-game benchmarks and this is how the performance of the cards look when using 16-bit. First of all, I have a strange phenomenon at 640x480 for both cards. We have lower frame rates than 800x600. I don't know why, but that's how it is. And because both cards have the same behavior, it means it's not a mistake on my part, because I've also repeated the tests. For the other resolutions, the differences are 45 and 58%. If we move to 32-bit, at 640x480, we have something strange again. Higher performance with 32-bit. So, we will ignore this resolution for now. When using the other resolutions, we have considerable drops for both video cards. And with the 8-bit card, we see somewhat larger differences, of around 78%, compared to 65% for the 128-bit model. However, no card can run the game at 1024x768 with good frames. 800x600 is the comfort zone for these cards, which fits pretty well with the time the card came out. 800x600 was a decent resolution in the early 2000s. Since we're still talking about Honest and the beginning of the 2000s, we have here Mafia, an Honest game about the American Mafia from the 30s. Relax, it was not the Mafia that was Honest, but our protagonist, Tommy Angelo, a taxi driver. This American taxi driver becomes a hitman for Don Salieri. So, we have Tommy, and I'm convinced that this name has nothing to do with the Tommy gun, who roams around the city in a yellow luxury car, a kind of 30s Rolls, at 20fps on the 8-bit and 30 plus on the normal card. Now, at 20fps the car looks like a Rolls, but moves like a Ford, and although I would exaggerate a bit if I said that the difference is double between the two cards, I will say it, the difference is double. Maybe the FPS is not really double, but the game really feels cut in half on the 8-bit card. I played Mafia like a mad lad when I was a teenager. I even skipped football, soccer for some of you, and football was always number one. I'm convinced that in 2003, on my then GeForce 2 MX400 card, I played this game using lower settings, unlike now when I'm using high, and I wasn't playing at 1024x768, but I still remember having lower performance than now. Does the CPU matter that much? I had an Atom XP 1700 Plus back then. And yet, back then I've managed to finish this race, without using any shortcut. What shortcut? Come on, you know, take a left here and get in front of everyone, because otherwise, 25% of us wouldn't go further than the second mission. Now you can choose the difficulty or skip the mission. Lest today's gamers don't know what to do in this race, where we are driving a car with four wheels and a steering wheel. Gaming today. Thank you all for watching, and until next time, have fun and be nostalgic.